Rick Tyndall, I'm from the Danvers Presbyterian Church, and we gave our members $1 and asked them to use it as the Lord directed them. And people did just all kinds of things, just amazing things, and we spelled them out basically in this brochure.
I'm an elder at Clinton Presbyterian Church in Clinton, Illinois, and our mission project is that we make homemade candy and fudge, and we have a booth at the Apple and Pork Festival every year, and the money from the Presbytery helped pay for the ingredients, and the proceeds went to local charities.
Presbyterian Church, and we had the Uganda Orphans Choir to come and visit our church, and basically they spent the weekend with us. We had them in their homes, we gave them a picnic and took them swimming, and so our children from Leroy had a chance to interact with children that they would never see in their world. And we asked them what their most pressing need was, and they stay and travel in the United States for a whole year, and many of them had grown so much during that time, they had outgrown their travel outfits. So they were kind of in a crisis for that special need, and we bought them jumpsuits or travel sweatsuits for them to wear when they were traveling. And the $100 was added to by other people when they saw the need. And so we have stayed in contact with them and hope that they'll be able to come back to our community again and have even more people involved in being ministers to them.
John Kay from Jacksonville First. We have a long-term friend in Springfield who's an artist, very concerned about Darfur. She created what I'm calling the Darfur tent. She had high school kids in Springfield decorate this, and then has loaned it to various congregations for raising public awareness. In our church, our staff developed an entire Vacation Bible School curriculum around the idea of the tent and camping. Camping with Christ. We did tents inside the church building, so the kids for Vacation Bible School got put into a tent every day. It was an intermixed ages of kids in each tent. It was learning about creation. They brought in a planetarium to look at the stars on one occasion. They had a petting zoo, which came on another occasion. Very exciting stuff for the kids. But it all focused on the fact that there are people in Darfur who only live in tents and who have no food or who have very little food and who need help cooking food. So they brought in their offerings, and people in the congregation assisted, and so we were able to raise $1,700 to send solar cookers into Darfur and teach the kids about caring for others. Kind of a fun thing.
My name is Clifford Hayes, pastor of First Presbyterian Church in Springfield, Illinois. And our church family sponsors a series of concerts that we bear the cost of putting on the concert. We've done an organ concert with a light show on All Saints Day. We've done 5 U2 Eucharists. We've done an 1850s carol sing with Abraham Lincoln. This is a picture of the light show, and I can even put that off pause. And in the last year and a half, we've raised over $14,000 for mission. 100% of the offering goes to mission, and then of course we pay for this the concerts. And so it's a unified ministry. So the $100 went to kind of was infused in this mission.
My name is Sue Bertelson. I'm from Little Cedar Presbyterian Church in Little York. What we did with our money is we bought more t-shirts, about $100 worth of t-shirts, to add to our existing 19-year program, Little York Logos. Each child is provided a free t-shirt when they come to our program. Our program runs after school from October through Easter. We provide Bible study, recreation, crafts, music, and a full sit-down dinner. Kids have a lot of fun with our program. And we have anywhere from 45 to 70 kids on any given
Jan hour. Costello, I'm with the Central Presbyterian Church in Petersburg, Illinois. And we did a project, a mission project called Bringing Hope. And basically, it was to help disaster victims who were affected by the floods along the Mississippi River. What had happened in really shortly after we received the talent check was that there was major flooding in June, and it affected many towns along the Mississippi River. They lost their homes, they lost their crops, they lost their farm animals. It was total devastation. So we decided that with our $100, we would try to raise a lot of money and get it over to the people along the Mississippi. So we advertised it in our local paper and talked about it to the congregation and put flyers around, and were able to raise $5,300. And we used that $5,300 to buy cleanup buckets, and we put those together in the church and sent them over along the Mississippi River. We sent several gift cards to the people who were affected by the floods, particularly those who lost their homes. And then we also would occasionally get requests for certain things that, in terms of construction materials that were needed. So we were able, fortunately, to purchase those and send them over. So we had a lot of people in our community helping out, not just our congregation, but the entire community, and all in the name of bringing hope, and we discovered that God's gift has no limits.
I'm Jim Strickland from the First Presbyterian Church in Geneseo, and we did a miniature golf outing, and fortunately one of our elders owned a miniature golf course, so he donated that, and then we took $50 donations from local businesses for each of the 18 holes, and then a $5 donation to play the miniature golf. So we took in a little under $2,000. And then we divided that up three ways. The first was $100 to another church to do something similar. And then we took the rest of the money and divided up between our food pantry and children's camp. So that's how we implemented the idea.
And I'm a member of the Biggsville Presbyterian Church. And what we did was a youth ministry where we have a meal after the football game. And it's called the fifth quarter. And after the football game, kids come back for tacos and pizza. And it's a way for some place for them to go. We're safe and a good environment. And we have good fellowship. And we have the kids come back, our parents come back, our football players, our coaches. We get a good turnout, and it's just a very safe environment.